Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel Trouble Free. In today's video, I'm going to explain about the destination sequence distance vector algorithm, which is in short called as DSDV. DSDV stands for destination sequence distance vector. Okay, in the subject of mobile computing, this is one of the very important routing algorithms. So listen carefully, make sure that you watch the video till the end. So now, it is a proactive routing algorithm. We have reactive, we have proactive, we have different types of routing algorithms, right? So in that, this belongs to proactive routing algorithm. Okay, and here, what is the main concept of DSDV? What is the main thing in DSDV is each node will have entire information about route in form of routing table. Suppose you are having two nodes in your network, then node 1 and node 2, both of them will have the information about the entire route, whatever the routes are there in the network, about all the routes, both of the nodes will be having the information, and in information in form of a routing table. Okay, I'll explain you with an example, then you'll understand it more clearly. So in DSDV algorithm, we have a routing table, right? A routing table is maintained for each and every node, and the routing table, what are the things that the routing table has are, it has a destination ID, it has a next node, it has the distance, which is nothing but the number of hops, and it also has the sequence number. Okay, it has the destination ID number 1. Destination ID is nothing but the destination from node 1 to node 2. If you are going, then node 2 will be your destination ID. Next node, what is its next node? And what is the distance? What is the distance between the two nodes? That means the source node and the destination node. And what is the sequence number? Sequence number can be any random number, okay? So, I'll explain you with an example. As I said, see, this is the example that we are going to consider. We have N1, N2, N3. So this is a network. In that network, we are having three nodes. And now if you are supposed to write a routing table for N1, how do you write? That is what we are going to figure it out now. Okay, see, in the routing table, as I said, we'll have destination number, next node, distance, and also sequence number. Okay, and this routing table which we are figuring out now is for N1, only for N1. And N2 will have a separate routing table and N3 will have a separate routing table. Okay, so let us see what we have in N1. So from N1, what is the destination ID? So what is the destination? You're going to N2. And what is the next node? Next node is also N2. And what is the distance? How many links you are having? How many hops you are having in between of N1 and N2? Only one, right? So the distance will be 1. Okay, and sequence number can be any random number. Like you can take 14. Okay, any random number, you can take it as a sequence number. Done. So from N1, you can go to N2 as well as you can go to N3 as well, right? So N3 also can be taken as a destination ID. So N3. Destination ID, but the next node will not change because the node which is very next to N1 is N2 only, right? You may get a doubt, if we come in this way, N3 is also next node, but we don't have any link, any path between N1 and N3, right? So you have to go this way only. So the next node would be N2, and now the distance will become, this is 1 and this is the second one, right? So the distance is 2 units here, and sequence number, again you can take randomly, let us take 18. Okay, so this is how you construct a routing table for a particular node. As I said, one node will have the information about the entire path, entire routing, entire route. So here N1 is having information about both N2 and also about the N3. Okay, so if you are constructing it for N2, here you have to write about N1 and also about N3. If you are doing it for N3, you have to write N1 and also N2. Okay, this is how destination sequenced distance vector routing algorithm will work. Okay, and again, whenever there are some changes, suppose if you want to add an extra node of N4 here or here, anywhere, if you want to add an extra node, then that updation should be done, right? So an extra node is added. So that updation can be done in two ways. Okay, number one is full dump, and number two is incremental update. So whenever a new node is added or an existing node is deleted, that is whenever you want to update anything in the routing table, then you can use two methods to do the updates. Okay, number one is full update and number two is incremental update. In full update or full dump, what you'll do is you will dump, you will be sending the entire routing table to your neighbor. So you will be sending the entire routing table, the word full, you can remember, entire routing table will be sent to the neighbor. In case of incremental update, what happens? Only the entries which are changed, only the things which are updated, only those things will be sent to the neighbor. Okay, in full dump, you will be sending the entire information irrespective of the change, and here you will be sending only the changed information. Okay, so these are the two methods by which you can update a change in this algorithm. Okay, done. So if you are adding an extra node N4, in case of full dump, you will be sending the entire table again. But in case of incremental update, you will be sending only information related to N4. That's it. Okay, so this is the difference between full dump and also incremental update. Done. So this is all about DSDV algorithm. And finally, I'll explain you the entire algorithm again. I mean, not again, like with an example, I'll explain you clearly, you will get more clearly, that means how to what happens when a node is deleted, or what happens when a new node comes, or what I'll explain you that. So now let us look at the example. So now let's consider this example, and we will generate routing table only for the node A. Okay, like how we are generating routing table for node A, for all the other nodes also you can generate in the same way, but I'm explaining you with A. Okay, first, what are the destinations you have? From A, you can go to B, you can go to C, you can go to D, you can go to E. You have many destinations from A. Okay, so first we will go with the B or C, anything. We'll go in alphabetical order. Okay, so B. And what is the next node to A? It's again B, right? And what is the distance from A to B? A to B, it's 1. Done. So the destination ID is B, next node is also B, the distance is 1, and the sequence number can be anything. Let's give randomly, like 340, let us give. Okay, now after this, so after B, what is the next thing we have? C. So the destination ID is C, and here the next node is also C again, and here the distance is again 1, and you can take sequence number anything. Let us take 188, any random number you can take. Now from A, you can, the next destination that you can go is B, or D, sorry. So D, and what is the next node? C. You can see, take the next node as B or C, anything, because from A to D you are traveling, then distance is 1 and 1 here, so total distance is 2. Even if you go through C also, the total distance is 2, so you can take anything, that's your choice. Okay, so let's go with C now. So C, let's take C. Now what would be the distance? 1 unit here and the other unit here, right? So here the distance will become 2, and let us take the sequence number as something like 174. Okay, now so what else is remaining? E is remaining, right? So let us take E, and you can come to E like A to C and C to E, or A to B, B to D and D to E. Among this, which is the shortest path? You have to go with the shortest path. Okay, if you are having multiple paths to a single node, to a single destination, in that case you can go with shortest path. So A to C and C to E, you are having only 2 distances here. From A to B, B to D and D to E, you are having 3. So it's better you go with 2. Okay, so here you'll get E, and the next node will be C, and distance will be 1 and 1, so it becomes 2, and you can take the sequence number like something like 162, let us take. Okay, so the sequence number can be anything. So this is how you will be constructing a routing table for a node. Okay, and for B also, for C also, for D, for E, you can construct in the same way. Okay, so this is all about the DSDV, construction of routing table in DSDV. So here, if you want to remove a particular node, then what happens if a particular node is disconnected suddenly? What happens then? The distance is to D for from all the nodes, the distance to B will become infinity, because D is removed, right? So the distance will become infinity, and all the nodes will be informed that, the neighboring nodes will be informed that the path to D has closed. That means there is no chance to go to D. So first, the distance to D will become infinity, and also the path to D will be closed. Okay, and this information will be updated to all the other neighbors, right? So that is what happens when a particular node is suddenly disconnected. Now after that, And also this D will be removed from the routing table. You can remove D from the routing table. Done. So now the routing table will become only B, C and E. So after some time, if D wants to come into the routing table again, that means if D wants to come into the network again, then what happens? D will be updated into the routing table. But here the sequence number which you are giving should be greater than the previous one. Previously 174 was its sequence number, right? So now you should give a number something greater than 174. Okay, so the second time when D is coming, the sequence number should be 176 or something greater than 174, greater than the previous sequence number should be given. Okay, done. So if D is disconnected, the distance to D will become infinity, the path will be closed and it will be removed from the routing table. Done. Again, if D wants to enter, you can update it into your routing table by giving a sequence number something greater than the previous one. Done. So this is all about DSDV algorithm. I hope you guys are clear about the video. If you're still having any doubts, let me know in the comment section. I'll definitely try to clear all your doubts for sure. And that's all for this video. Let's meet up soon in the next coming video with another topic. And also let me know in the comment section what are the other videos I can do, because this video was suggestion for me. 2-3 people asked me to make this video and I did. So I'll be very happy if you guys give me suggestions to make videos. So that's all. If you're still having any doubts, feel free to comment it. And also, I'll give you my contact details in the description. You can contact me as well. If you have clearly understood whatever I've explained in the video, hit the like button and also share it with your friends. And also, if you have not yet subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you can receive the notifications whenever I post a video. So let's meet up soon in the next coming video. And thank you for watching my video.